On this storm's latest track for that, we will check in with meteorologist Joseph Dames. Where is Dorian moving now?
Dorian is still moving to the west. This is actually a loop over the last 6 hours, beginning right around noon to 6 p.m. our time here. And notice it's not going very far. This is moving very slowly. Still a very strong hurricane. Category 5 hasn't seen a change there. We've seen sustained wind speeds up to about 180 plus miles per hour. Okay, still 150 something miles away from the Florida coast there. That's just the eye. And a reminder, you only had to be about 45 miles away to experience the hurricane force winds, 74 miles per hour or above. So that could still cause problems even when it starts to push off to the north, which is where the tracking is as of right now as we look at the cone here, and expecting to keep that category 5 hurricane for some time, possibly going down to about a category 4, but still very, very strong before reaching maybe Georgia and South Carolina there. Again, wind about 185 miles per hour, and then you could even experience maybe upwards to about 220 mile per hour wind gusts. That is very, very, very dangerous. Okay, so here's another look. These are actually a couple of the weather miles. You can see the lines here, and a couple of them have it targeting right into about the central Florida coast, and possibly a little bit further out, depending on which track it does take, but at least in an agreement that it's going to start veering to the north. Best possible case, it gets pretty far out there, and we're experiencing maybe there's some wind from the distance. Okay, there's a hurricane warning there, hurricane watch, and you can see a tropical storm watch. Miami is just out of that boundary there, but you could also experience the tropical storm force winds up to about 100 plus miles away, and that could be anywhere from about 40 miles per hour plus. The wind forecast as we go through the rest of this evening into the overnight, here we go. It gets really strong, pretty close to the coast there before it starts to maybe veer to the north. Again, still uncertain, and we'll see how it does play out. Some of the hazards, as I mentioned, wind gusts over 220 miles per hour. That's enough to take a roof off, knock over the side of a frame house. Storm surge up to 18 to 23 above the normal tide. What we're looking for is, well, movement over land would weaken it a little bit, or some cooler waters or drier air, but likely not going to see any of these. So we'll continue to forecast, and we'll look at this as we go through the next couple of hours. In the meantime, I'll get to our local forecast here in about 10 minutes, Emily. All right.